Hi, I'm Jeff, and this is Lithic Metals. Welcome to the lab. I got a cool series that I'm going to start today. I'm going to start a collection of new 1/10 ounce pieces, 3.1 grams. I have a collection of vintage dyes that, I just think they're cool. I have them sitting around in the lab. And I admire the detail, and I thought a few months ago, I thought, wouldn't it be cool to start bringing some of these back to life? So that is what I've been starting to do. And so these rounds that I'm going to make today, they're not too unsimilar to the gold bug rounds that I made earlier in the year. Each one is going to be an individual, slightly different, although I'm using dies and presses. I'm not making exact copies over and over again, but I think this is going to be a cool series. The subject is no less than Mercury, and this is my concept piece. I should say proof of concept, and I'm going to mark this as number one. Unlike the gold bug rounds, I'm able to stamp a lithic mark on the back of this one, even though it's so tiny, but I think it turned out great, and what I'm hoping to do today is make 20 more. So I have a little over 2 ounces of gold here, and I'm going to start weighing these up. As a matter of fact, let's get this going. I'm going to weigh up 20 batches of 3.1 grams, and turn those all into buttons. Unlike the gold bug rounds, I'm not going to hand hammer these. I am going to use the press, so that's going to be a little something different that we'll take a look at. And let's just get started, huh? I'm going to switch this over to ounces. Troy ounces. Tear it out. Piece is too heavy as is. I didn't think I had any pieces that were more than. I think I just grabbed a couple in one pinch. There we go. Dang it all. I'm gonna get this. let's stay at this bench and I'm just gonna get set up to melt the buttons here. Alright, I think we're all set. Let's turn the fan on and make some buttons. Thank you. next step is to take these over to the fume booth and give them a quick boil in 10% dilute sulfuric acid. That will remove any of the glazing, any of the borax that might have stuck to the bottom of it. You don't want to crush that stuff into your piece. So let's switch over. We have our buttons made and we are ready to start with the press. So I'm going to take this die and get us set up over here. All right, so here we have our press. Now I'm going to set this on our die ahead of time here. Center it out. Now, if any of you are familiar with working with dies and presses, please feel free to chime in with any tips you might want to offer. This is basically all experimental to me. And, well, I have done some practice pieces already, but I still feel like each one is a new experiment. It took me several attempts to get to the point where I considered keeping the piece as number one. And it wouldn't surprise me if a few of these went in the wrong direction and I had to melt them down into buttons again, but we're gonna go through these 20. See how many we can get out of it. If we have to, we'll melt whatever percentage of them down and do it again. We'll do them until we get them looking sharp and respectable. So what I'm going to do here is I am going to use this plate instead of a different block. And I just want to judge how much distance I have here. I'm going to go down a bit. Really, I'm just using this now to flatten it out. If I use it with this isn't perfectly smooth, and this way I just can control everything a little more evenly. I have several blocks that I also would use, but shucks. See, I need to quit talking and just focus on what I'm doing here. So I put that filter there to create the texture that I'm looking for, and it breaks apart as the as it makes contact with the gold and stretches out. And I like the texture. I experimented with a few different ways here, and this is what I'm enjoying. Now what I want to do is focus on. It's kind of a heavy-duty jack. I just want to focus on not going too far. Right there, I think. have our first one. And there's going to be a couple different steps, depending on how they turn out. I'm going to press out another piece right away. Switching it up a little bit. I think if I press them all and then I can go back and do the lithic stamp, I think that's a better way to go. It's not how I started. I did each piece individually, so my practice pieces up until I got number one. So now that we're ready to go into production, I think we can do it this way. Feels about right. Yeah, like I was saying, if anybody is more familiar with working with dies and presses, please feel free to offer your tips. And for those of you that aren't as familiar, well, we can learn this together here. Another successful strike. Press. Tap this off quick. And let's do another one. think they look great. Still have a little bit of work to do on them, though. Alright, our first step here is going to be to get these red hot again. And I'm going to... some of these have the filter paper still stuck on the back. And I could probably just wash that off with water, but it'll burn off just as easy. And it's ashless paper, so it won't leave a residue or anything. So let's get to it. Turn this fan off. Oh man, they look great. They look great. Now it's time to stamp them up, put the finishing touches on them. I'm gonna let this cool down a minute and then I'll clean it up and I'll get set up for the next process. Reheated all of these to basically anneal them and get all the atoms straightened out, soften the metal, so it'll be easier for us to strike the lithic mark on the back. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to use our die to hold each piece. Fit them back in there. There they go. Boy, these feel great. You put a couple in one spot and they're so heavy for being so tiny. Tricks your brain. All right. next step. I just want to fine-tune a few of these as I go. And... oh, there we go. In order to do that, I need to trade up.
Yeah, trading up.
Alright, and that's not all. I need to actually be able to see while I'm working here. And this loop won't do for this process. They're looking good. They're looking pretty sharp. I think it's time to, wow. I think our next step is going to be, to get our capsules ready. I'm gonna put each one of these in a capsule and box, and, we'll get them ready to ship out. This gold marker will wear off if it's rubbed, but it's basically just to send it off in. Just so. Now I'm going to get them in order and make sure they stay that way. I'm looking forward to upgrading this camera. Simply don't get the video quality that at least that my eyes see. Alright. alright, mission accomplished. Finished the first 21 pieces from Lithic's new 1/10 ounce Mercury round series. This is going to be a cool collection. It already is. I love it. I love how this die turned out. It's like snatching a piece right out of the past. I really like the idea of using these old vintage dies instead of just having them sitting on my shelf. I've been having some fun with them. It's a learning process. It's something that I've never done before, so it's been a little trial and error. You wouldn't think it'd be that complicated, but I think I've only scratched the surface. So if anybody's got tips or anything they want to throw at me, or ideas, safety issues, anything that they noticed that while I was working on that press, please let me know. I'd appreciate the help. But in the meantime, I'm going to keep learning by doing and creating a few more pieces. So we got 21, well, this is number 21, right? Yeah, this is number 21. And it just so happens that today is the 21st. And it's also my birthday. So 21 pieces, 21st, my birthday. This is gonna end up, I'm gonna keep this one from my collection. I didn't plan it out, it wasn't strategic, just kind of a cool coincidence, so, yeah, I'm going to keep it. Plus, I'd be happy to have one of the early pieces to this collection. This is a fun one. This is about as close as I've gotten to the gold bugs rounds pictured in this photo here. That was a great, great collection. And this is about as close as I've gotten since. So this is a fun one to start. And I know I put a little video up to see if there's going to be any interest with the group. And I got like 30, 40 people, maybe, that asked to be tagged to the actual sales post. And unfortunately, I only have 20 to offer. It might even be less than that. I have one or two longtime customers that requested one, so I might have to remove one or two, but we'll have at least like 15 to offer to the group. So that's not going to satisfy everybody right off the bat. So in a couple weeks, I'll make another batch. It won't be too long if the demand is there. And yeah, we'll see. I think I'm going to cap these pieces off. I haven't made it official, but I think I'm going to cap these off at 250 for the collection. You know, I debate with setting those numbers because, you know, it might be something I want to make for years down the road, but I think it'll be fun to, yeah, let's make it official. We'll cap these at 250 pieces for this collection. Hopefully that'll create value being a somewhat smaller collection. And, well, I'm not going to commit to retiring the die. Perhaps I might develop a quarter ounce series, or maybe I can work out a gram. I don't know. Or I even fancied the idea of doing little silver rounds. I think that would look pretty tight as well. I just don't know if they would be cost effective. You know, a lot of work goes into making it, and what are you going to make it out of, like a 2/10 of an ounce of silver? And I don't know, I don't, but we'll see. So I'm not going to commit to retiring the die, but I will commit to making only 250 of these, and I think that'll be, that should pretty well satisfy demand, I'd imagine. Hopefully I'll be able to sell that 250. I think they're such awesome pieces that I think folks are going to enjoy them. I do. And plus having Lithic stamped on the back, and that's a nice improvement for me. I was happy to be able to figure that out without destroying the front. So these are a good set. I hope everybody who purchases one enjoys it as much as I do. Now I'm offering these to the Gold Bugs community. And I've gotten a couple requests from folks saying, hey, how do I get one of your pieces? Well, I've been selling exclusively through Gold Bugs for almost a year now. But it's not necessarily easy to get into gold bugs. There's a long waiting list. The admins do a lot of due diligence and vet everybody that requests to come in, so it could take weeks or months even to get into the group. There are like 800,000 people behind, I think I heard, so that they got to catch up with, and they keep getting more requests, so it could take a while. So what I did was, a couple weeks ago, I created a pretty simplistic website, lithicmetals.com, and I don't have a storefront on there, but maybe over the next week or two, I'll add that. And I think what would be fun would be to create a collection strictly for YouTube viewers. And once I get that storefront up, we'll do a cool collection. We'll make a video of that, and I'll offer it to you guys on YouTube. I think a lot of my YouTube subscribers are gold bug members, so I don't. We'll see how that goes. But I want to be able to reach a few folks that have been reaching out to me, and I appreciate that so much. And for anybody that considers adding a lithic piece to their collection, thank you. That's so awesome. I got a couple cool videos coming up in the future, working with these dyes. I got like this beauty here. This is a half ounce, early Native American image. It's just stunning. The detail is amazing in this dye, and it's such a great piece. So I made a video of making this piece. We'll see if I can edit it together. Otherwise, I'll do a video of creating one of the next ones, because that was a fun one. A lot of trial and error on these as well, but fun process. I think I have a good handful of dyes that have been sitting around, and I think I'm going to put them to good use. So, well, I think we could probably wrap this up. Here's our first 21 pieces of the new 1/10 ounce gold Mercury round collection. I hope you enjoyed watching the process. Definitely appreciate you joining me. Thank you so much. I'm Jeff. This is Lithic Metals, and I'll see you next time.